Hello and welcome to Faith and Friends. As always, we're happy to spend the next 30 minutes with you here, and we're praying that your week is going well. If not, know right now that God is still right there by you. Trust Him through everything you're going through. The week can still get better.
Alongside Andy Lynch and Jennifer Beck, I'm Mark Koontz. The idea of trusting God through all things is a theme here at our station this week as we're mourning the loss of two individuals very close to the heart of WTLW. Coming up on today's show, we remember Keith Kettner, husband to Sherry Kettner, who passed away September the 16th. Plus, a majority of our show will be dedicated to TV 44 founder Ron Mile, who passed away September 22nd. Last week, we brought you a verse about battles with a reminder that the battle is not ours, but the Lord's. And that is important to always remember because you're truly never know when life will change forever. And today's verse is a reminder and a comfort for those dealing with sadness. Andy?
No question about it. Psalm 46:1-4 is where we turn. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling, there's a river whose streams shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. We take our refuge, we take our hope in our Father in heaven and in the eternity that He has placed on our hearts.
Well, Sunday, September 21st, I received an email from a viewer letting me know that TV 44 station founder Ron Mile was in the final days or maybe even the final hours of his life. Surrounded by his entire family, the Mile family was preparing for this new season. They knew what lie ahead for Ron, an eternal home in heaven. Knew that was the best place for him. Last Monday morning, Ron stepped into that new home, and as we join together to mourn with and pray for the Mile family, we also want to step back and remember the incredible impact Ron Mile had and still has on this region. It was his vision that launched TV 44 into what it is today, with the station signing on the air more than 30 years ago. Here's a look back at some of the memories from the past 30 years.
We are to dedicate this to the honor and to the glory of the Lord, and what a privilege it is. So.
God is with us till the end of the age. He is with us even though the battles rage. Emmanuel, oh, I live to tell everyone that God is with us. I remember you.
How does Larnell feel about being the performer mainlining the new Celebration of Faith?
What a privilege it is for me to be here and to see this day be a celebration as unto the Lord, as it should be.
Behind the lights, the tinsel and the noise. Thanks, but no thanks, old Mr. Satan. I turned around, I found another way.
On today's edition of That's Unkiddable, we'll be hearing another story from talented storyteller Dot Groves.
Then we'll learn about some interesting research that will make flying safer.
We're family entertainment, the life you're looking for. TV 44, watch us for life. Watch us for life.
Do not be afraid.
Yeah! National Pork Rind Appreciation Day Eve!
Guide her around to the little kids and let the little kids come up to get pictures with her. And
Buster's deflating. Luke, has Buster ever fallen down?
Not yet, but it looks like she's about to.
Well, we need a little help here. We're losing Buster over here, but maybe a Turning Point t-shirt from Company 26 will help Buster get back on her feet here.
That's better than a 7-foot cowbell.
That's one of the funniest things I've seen.
We'll have a few more of those memories throughout our time today.
It was communication that TV 44's founder Ron Mile truly loved, particularly communicating the gospel. And because of his vision and determination, TV 44 is what it is today.
I got into radio having been healed of stuttering just 2 weeks before. And I went through the worst interview anyone has ever had in the history of man.
Are you an announcer? I said, no, I've only been talking for 2 weeks.
Ron Miles' ministry in radio did take off, leading him to a distinguished career as general manager at Lima's WTGN Radio. However, Ron was ready for new challenges, and one day, a man by the name of Les Raker told Ron that God had something planned for the Lima area.
That God had spoken that there's supposed to be Christian TV in Lima.
Ron and WTGN would raise the initial seed money to start WTGN-TV in the mid-1970s. After a time, WTGN decided to focus just on Christian radio, and Ron left everything he knew to pursue TV 44. One of the first things Ron had to do was go back to school to learn about television production.
Then I was older than anybody in the room. I mean, I was in my, in my 30s, I guess, still. And they said, what are you interested in this for? I said, because we're going to build a TV station. Oh, real doubtingly said that. Did I care? No.
Next on the list was getting believers and churches in the area behind the vision of Christian television for Lima. And as it turned out, it wasn't an easy task.
We had a lot of opposition from the Christian. It's tough to talk about, but there were members of the Christian community who said, this will never fly.
Again, Ron held strong to his vision and moved forward. He believed that Christian television could be more than preachers at a pulpit. It could be entertaining as well as inspirational.
I knew we could turn this thing around whereby it would become a normality to have something coming across the screen that glorified Jesus Christ, made clear the plans of God, and we'd see souls saved. And that's the vision I had for it.
To produce local shows, Ron wanted a studio. That's when he found the old abandoned Lima Airport, located on Beatty Road.
I'd been shopping, and I knew about this. This was 60 by 80, I believe, and it's clear span. To anyone who doesn't understand, there's no posts holding up the ceiling and to get in the way of camera shots. I thought, this has possibilities.
Now with a building, Ron needed labor to convert the old airport into a television studio. That's when an army of volunteers who began to see Ron's vision, armed with tools, came to help out on weekends.
They just come in and they didn't expect anything but a lunch. And we always usually had pizza. And it had some good fellowship. That was fun. The people thought nothing of just giving of their time. Bless their hearts.
And a staff began to form. Former WTGN members Keith Curtis, Miriam Nungester, and John Marshall. And God sent a man with a set of skills Ron desperately needed.
Roger Rhodes had stepped on the scene, and thank God for him. He taught television production on a college level. Talk about a godsend.
Not everything went as planned. Ron had an idea of the main studio having a rotating stage for local shows.
We were in Chicago at CBS picking up anything that was free. I told their chief engineer, who happened to be a Christian, what we were up to. And I said, we've got a rotating stage in mind, and we can just have that portion already lit. And when we're going to change, divide it into thirds, we wanted to change programs, we just give it a spin. He says, Ron, that sounds like a great idea. He did, he said that. Boy, I wish he hadn't.
Ron's rotating stage may never have received an award, but his faithfulness to the overall vision was rewarded when, against all the odds, TV 44 signed on the air on June 13th, 1982.
I'll tell you another thing that did. Some of these Christians who weren't behind us, heartbreaking though it is, they saw that we were going the way of the cross, and they came around. And some have come to me and said, I'm sorry that we didn't support you early in.
TV 44 was producing multiple local programs, including some that were live. But during the 80s, TV44's fundraisers were some of the most entertaining and inspirational live programs of that era. On the air live, sometimes for as much as 5 hours a night, and anything could happen.
Behind me here is the Victory Club. Say Victory Club. Yes, we have, stop saying it now.
Oh, those were fun days. Those telethons, they're out of fashion now, but they were sure fun while they lasted.
Ron left TV 44 in the early 1990s to pursue launching TV 40 in Toledo, which he now serves as a board member. But his allegiance is still strong to the station he helped launch 3 decades ago.
As long as we keep focused on the cross of Jesus Christ, I'm behind you guys, and I know that's in the heart of everyone who works here.
Ron still remains humbled by the achievements of his hard work so many years ago.
Anyone could have done what I did, and that's not being Joe Humble. It's just I'm the one who went ahead and did it. And that can't, there's not much room for pride in that, except pride in Jesus Christ and what he stands for.
It's amazing all the work and dedication that went in to start TV44.
Oh, absolutely. As you can see, it is no accident that TV44 exists. When God has a plan, he has a way to make it happen. 30 years ago, TV44 was one of just a few Christian, locally owned television stations, and now, 3 decades later, we remain as a small minority still working to do the work of Jesus Christ.
The big reason for that is our commitment to locally produced programming, whether it's sports, whether it's getting in the community. We try and be all over West Ohio. Here's some more highlights from the last 30 years.
Is that is that a crime not to be Christian? Let me ask people, is that a crime not to be Christian? Can I believe in any other religion? Apparently no.
Well, no, because I don't get influenced by rock music.
They're one of the hottest groups today, Audio A, and their new CD, Underdog, is tearing up the charts.
We all love music, you know. A lot of kids that love music want to be in rock bands growing up, but we also happen to be in love with the Lord.
There's an admonition right here in this book that tells me to forgive my enemies, but I know it's easier to do after you've gotten even.
But on April 20th, 1999, the name Columbine also became synonymous with tragedy. Within 24 hours of the shooting, Straight Talk went to Colorado with our cameras to get Straight Talk from the survivors of this tragedy.
And I saw these two ladies praying for this girl that is fighting for her life because she did have an abortion. And the Lord spoke to me in a real, real way. And he showed me how wrong I was to hold the view that I did, that abortion was a political issue, it was a woman's right, it was okay. And God showed me that. He told me it was wrong. And I am so glad and thankful to God that he opened my eyes to this important issue and showed me what is really going on.
I want to thank you, and you have my forgiveness, and for everyone in earshot here who forgives her, let's hear it.
On Monday night, we saw a rededication and a salvation. Tuesday, a rededication. A marriage was rededicated.
When she said that I had AIDS, and that's just the way she said, the first thing popped my mind, I can't have AIDS. And she left.
How far have we come in the fight against AIDS? Not just in the search for a cure, but have we really gotten to the heart of the matter? How we treat the person behind the disease?
Well, it's been a week of double loss for the TV 44 family. Many of you still regard former TV 44 producer Sherry Kettner as someone near and dear to your hearts, as certainly we do. September 16th, Sherry's husband Keith passed away. Sherry always said that part of what drew her to TV 44 was the fact that through it, her husband came to know Christ. She worked at the station for about 17 years. During that time, Keith certainly became close with many here, as well as likely rubbed shoulders with many of you.
Sherry left TV 44 in September of 2011 when she and Keith relocated to Florida, a place that doctors felt would be a positive place for his health issues. and they did enjoy 3 wonderful years there together. A memorial service was held in Ohio earlier in September, and burial will be in Florida. If you'd like to send a card to Sherry, you are welcome to send it here to TV 44, and we will forward it on to her in Florida.
As we rejoice that both Ron Mile and Keith Kettner were believers, it does not eliminate the hurt the family and friends have left to process. If you'd like to send a card to either of them, as Jennifer said, Becky Mile or Sherry Kettner, you can send that here as well. We'll forward it appropriately. In the meantime, let's take a moment to pray for the family and the friends of both these families. Father, our hearts are heavy as we lift up the Mile family, also the Kettners. God, they've meant so much to us. They've meant so much to this region. And we celebrate that Keith and Ron are in heaven together. And we pray, Lord, for the families that have been left behind, that they would take refuge in you, that you would comfort them, and they would be able to celebrate the lives that have been passed. We thank you so much that you are the creator and you have our eternal destiny in mind if we turn to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Of course, Ron Mile had a major hand in the past 30-plus years at TV 44. Sherry also incredibly instrumental as well, just 2 of the dozens of individuals that God has brought through these station doors to use for his glory. It was in the 80s that the notion of sports was brought to the table. We're going to continue our look back at the 30 years of TV 44 with a short look at the way God has used sports as an open door to share the gospel with the region.
Following is a presentation of TV 44 Sports.
There's no match for the love of high school sports in our area. The paint was still drying on our studio when TV 44 got the bug to start using sports as a way to draw a new audience to this TV station that aired Preachers. John Ondo is the production director and remembers just how 44 Sports got off the ground.
We had a lot on our plate in the mid-80s at TV 44, but I had this guy on my staff by the name of Tom Hendrickson. He was a former sports writer. And he lobbied and lobbied and lobbied that we should do high school basketball coverage on TV 44. And we gave it a shot.
WTLW TV 44 Sports is proud to bring you the finest in area high school basketball action.
TV 44 Sports in the mid-1980s when we started it was myself and a few other guys literally scrounging through the station at about 3 p.m. on Friday, digging up whatever VCRs, cables, cameras, microphones we could get our hands on, and then throwing in a Dodge Caravan and driving out to some game and just praying the whole time, please, Lord, let the cables work.
Mike Shepp and Mark Miller were the broadcasters from November to March. The games were instant hits. High school students so excited to see the TV 44 truck pull up to broadcast their game. And by the 1990s, TV 44 Sports had become such a part of the fabric of West Ohio sports culture that we even had a theme song.
The Jingle by Kelly Connor and Jim Bodecker, that was huge. When we went to basketball games and would set up, we'd hear people singing the song. And we knew at that point that 44 Sports had become part of the culture of West Ohio.
Basketball led to football.
Rolling to his right, throws deep down the field. Man, wide open. That's Lee at the 30.
I remember the first football game we did because I was worried that we were going to kill somebody because there was a lightning storm that came by. And we literally did take a lightning hit off the van and one of our cameras burned up. And I said, I'm done with football.
Eventually, 44 Sports would bring in a new team of sports junkies who would put together a nightly sports wrap called Sports Report in 2005.
8 area divers qualifying for state yesterday in the Division II district meet. Finley trying to add to that number in the D1 finals.
Boys victorious in NWC play last night against Bluffton.
But at the center of all the sports excitement is the real reason we do all of this. A reward that TV 44 staff knew from the very beginning would pay dividends.
one of the greatest memories I have ever had in broadcasting is after a long season with 44 Sports with basketball, we came back in from Columbus from shooting probably a semifinal or something like that, exhausted, late at night, and up on a marquee at a local bar was, we'll have TV44's game, LCC or Lima Senior, whatever the school was, here tonight. A bar advertising it's going to run a Christian television station's content. That, greatest reward I've ever had in my life. That's why we do sports. That's why we made the commitment and we broke our backs so many years ago, and why the current guys are breaking their backs now, is because we know it brings an audience to the station that would never watch a religious television station, but they love sports and we love sports. Totally what I think Jesus would do today.
Still today, we see God using sports as a way to share the light of Christ with our region. So much happening around the area and fellowship of Christian athletes as well. In fact, we're planning a coaches retreat January 30th and 31st in St. Mary's, and the 29th and 30th for ministry workers and pastors. So if your coach or your pastor needs some time away, or perhaps you'd like to give this as a gift, you can let me know, alynch@wtlw.com. Going to be a great day down in St. Mary's and a great night. Well, last week, we finished our second FCA training, nearly 100 students and coaches coming together, including some from Wapakoneta. In fact, four Redskin juniors have a message for you.
Come to Fields of Faith!
On October 8th.
7 to 9 p.m.
Everybody come, it's going to be great!
That event will have a student band, student speakers like Shelby Lucas of UNOH and Anna football player Matthew Bruce. And it'll also feature former Wapakoneta standout Alex Tuttle, who has turned his life around after drug addiction. It should be a fantastic night at Harmon Field. We encourage all to attend. But we also had a couple fantastic training sessions at Faith Alliance Church in New Bremen in August, and then last Sunday, right here at TV 44.
I got a lot out of it personally. I got a lot out of it, what we want to do with our FCA, things we can fix and make better, and just getting to know everyone's ideas. I was able to talk with a lot of other groups, and they really showed me what they do in comparison to what we do, and I had a lot of ideas to do here now.
God's been teaching the junior golfer a lot recently.
To trust him, trust his plan, because sometimes it's not what I want, but it obviously works out. I really want to make a difference and make an impact on people's lives, so it's really exciting for me to be able to have the opportunity to do that.
Zach Bowers joins us with an all-important update on the auction cow. Last week we shared with you this, what Jennifer likes to call a critter.
Yeah, I don't understand that. How is a cow a critter?
A bovine, a future beef.
A hamburger.
Steak, you know, there's lots of names. I would not say critter. But anyway, we were getting into the process of getting a new name for this beef.
That's right. Well,
as
you know by now, it's become one of the most popular auction items that we've had. And last week you may have heard that Brandit Marketing was hosting a naming contest for their new friend, with nine names making the final round.
Wow.
After a tie between Sweet Cowerline and Calvin, it turns out that it is Sweet Cowerline of Mooser County.
Oh, wow.
Is the new name for this auction cow, and Sweet Cowerline is currently enjoying her new home at the offices of Brandit Marketing, currently living amidst the flowers and garden area.
The critters.
Yeah, the critters, maybe.
Okay, there they are.
But however, a recent post on the Brandit Facebook page encourages viewers to stay tuned to find out where Sweet Cowerline will be seen next.
So this is going to be a weekly segment here on Faith.
It may be.
I have a feeling. Where is
Sweet
Cowerline?
Where in the world is Sweet Cowerline? You know, who knows?
Someday Zach will be riding the cow and be a cowboy.
That's an option. If you'd like to sponsor that segment of me riding Sweet Cowerline around maybe the building here, the studio, that would be a good sponsorship.
Jennifer, can you look into that?
I think there's amazing things that we could do. I don't think we want to use that in one of our food segments, though.
No. Well, I could ride him
around.
Is
this where I remind you guys that it's a fake cow, so you can't really make hamburger steak out of it? Oh. And you probably could ride it, but it supports your weight, but I don't think it'd really be able to move you anywhere because it's not
wheels.
A real cow.
I like
that. Cart
that move you anywhere.
Around. I'd put it on wheels and Andy would push me around the parking lot.
So would you like to see Zach ride a cow on wheels around the parking lot? The sponsorship is available. And we are still looking for the 6'7" tall cake. even though the auction is over?
I think we found it. It was eaten so quickly that nobody actually had a chance to see it.
It was good.
It's quite possible.
Strawberry.
Once again, we do want to say thank you to all who were involved in the auction in some way, whether it was donating, bidding, volunteering, an incredible event. We're very thankful. Believe it or not, you can already start thinking about ways to get involved in next year's auction. We're even willing to start taking your furniture donations now.
What?
Here's, yeah.
What?
Yes,
we're willing to put it.
That's not my problem. We'll find room for your furniture donations.
We'll put them in his office.
Yep. Well, we did move some things around in the sports office, so perhaps
there
we can do it there. But here's a way you can tell us what you plan to donate, and you can tweet it to us.
Oh, wow. You can also find us on Twitter and other ways. Mark Koontz 44, Andy Lynch 44, Jen Beck 44, Matt Finkel 44, Bauer Z.
Yeah.
44?
I have my own line there. No, it's just Bauer Z, but I have my own line on that graphic there.
Are you too good for the 44?
No. No. I just, wanted to be different.
Zach does like to be different. You can also like us on Facebook. You're not on Facebook, are you?
I am, but you can find
that's
both Jennifer.
That's top secret. I didn't know that.
He is Secret Bauer Z on Facebook.
Secret Bauer Z.
If you find me on Facebook, I will be your friend if you find me. So, bit of a challenge there. But before we go, just a few things to watch out for. The latest Take One newsletter does arrive in your mailbox this week. And also some special TV programming this month of October, including Serving Israel's Farmers, the story of Chaya Vel and how Christians from the United States went to Israel with a simple plan of serving, and how that has been an open door to spread the love of Christ. You can see Serving Israel's Farmers here on TV 44 October 10th at 8 p.m. and October 22nd at 9.
That sounds like a good one. Coming up next week on Faith and Friends, we will meet an Operation Christmas Child recipient and hear what that means to her. Plus, we start the first of 3-week ticket giveaways with tickets to Inspirations on Broadway featuring Ernie Haas and Signature Sound, Jennifer's favorite.
Yeah. Now we close with one more look at our scripture of the day, Psalm 46, 1 through 4. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling, there is a river whose stream shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. Where the valleys are high or low, God wants to walk with you. We close with one more remembrance of Ron Miles, TV 44 station founder, who passed away September 22nd.
Oh, my Sunday school pin was too long for my coat, and it hung all the way to the floor. I had not missed a Sunday in 43 years, and next year would have been 44. It began on the morn of the day that I was born, when the cradle roll added my name. And through richer and poorer, through sickness and health, my attendance went on just the same. Here's the good part. 40 years without missing a single service. I guarantee it got to be rather nervous, but it stopped short when I fell and broke my shin, when I tripped on my Sunday school pin.
WTLW. Let's welcome the good guys.
Uh-oh.
Wait, which parts are we singing?
I don't know. What are you singing?
I don't know. Are you singing lead again?
I'm doing number 90.
I'm okay. Are you okay?
I was doing 91.
Anyone could have done what I did, and that's not being Joe Humble. It's just I'm the one who went ahead and did it, and that can't. There's not much room for pride in that, except pride in Jesus Christ and what He stands for.